Hi, my name is Gigi Jibalisco, and this is This Week in Mountain Athletics.
Lamar, spin move, drive inside, dump over to Julian from the corner. Shot,
got it, and he hit it!
What?
Heart!
What?
Goals!
What?
Team value!
Welcome to the 8th edition of This Week in Mount Athletics. Once again, I am senior Gigi Jibalisco, member of the Mount St. Mary's men's cross-country and track and field teams, and your host for this week. We had an exciting week of soccer at Waldron Stadium. So let's start the show off with the Mount women's soccer team, who had a pair of exciting victories at home. The Mount women's soccer team won two games in a weekend for the first time since 2004 after defeating Central Connecticut State 1-0 on Friday and then erupted for four goals in a 4-1 victory against Quinnipiac on Sunday for Senior Day. Senior Sadie Winship scored the Mount's goal against the Blue Devils to secure the victory. Senior Alicia Miller made five saves in the game and earned her 11th career shutout to become the program's all-time career leader in the category. On Sunday, freshman Alicia Morando stole the spotlight with a pair of goals in the second half to seal the victory. The freshman was named NEC Rookie of the Week for her efforts. Mount St. Mary's also got goals from junior Kelly Baker and sophomore Jackie Corley. Miller made three saves against the Bobcats. Women's soccer teams currently sits 1 point out of the final playoff spot going into the final weekend of play.
They're spectacular young ladies. I knew that when I recruited them when they were in high school, and they have for 4 years never disappointed me, never disappointed Mount St. Mary's University, and have been nothing but the prototype for what we want here at Mount St. Mary's. Happy to go to work. Happy to go to work this week, and you know, certainly to have some purpose to our travels this weekend is what we've talked about. And you know, Bryan and Sacred Heart are two very tough opponents, and again, we're away. But we're going to work hard. We're going to stay positive, get kids healthy, and we will represent Mount St. Mary's very well this weekend.
The Mount's men's soccer team capped off a great weekend at Waldron Family Stadium with thrilling double overtime victories. Mount St. Mary's defeated Quinnipiac 2-1 thanks to sophomore Jimmy Ockford's goal in the 107th minute off of helpers from senior Chris Wheeler and sophomore Patrick Wheeler. Senior Ian Hendry tied the game at 1 in the 8th minute. Junior Pete Steve made three saves in the win. Prior to the game, the Mount honored its four seniors. The Mountain proved to 6-1 at home this season and remains in the hunt for a postseason berth with three games left.
We have one more home game is our next NEC game. You know, we're taking all the games one game at a time. We have three left. We know we still got to win in order to get in the tournament. And, you know, our focus will be on next Friday night. We'll train all week for it and hopefully prepare the boys to where they're comfortable and confident to go out and get that match. So we're looking forward to the game and looking forward to the rest of the season. We feel very comfortable as a team to try to achieve our goal, which is trying to get to the tournament. You know, every team in the conference has that goal. When you get into, you know, seven games played, if you're still alive to make one of the top four teams, you know, you're still in the hunt and you keep fighting. And that's where we are. We're still going to concentrate. We're going to come to work every day, train. We're going to make sure that the guys are prepared. You know, and we're going to still continue trying to do what we do best, which is, you know, play within ourselves, play the simple game, and, you know, keep our heads throughout the whole 90 minutes. And, you know, if we do that, then hopefully success will follow.
The Mount men's and women's tennis teams completed their fall slate over the weekend. On the men's side, the Mount defeated Ryder 6-1 on Saturday and Wagner 6-1 on Sunday. Freshman Adam Selim, junior Mike Solomon, junior Taylor Place, and freshman Patrick McGinley won their singles match in both competitions. On the women's side, the Mountaineers defeated Ryder 7-0 on Saturday and Wagner 6-1 on Sunday. Junior Kelly Conroy, junior Renee Deanne, junior Carly Landini, and sophomore Liz Rossi each won both of their singles match on the weekend. The Mount women's swimming team returns to action on Saturday and lost 146-106 to Wagner. Sophomore Kat Koppler paced the Mount with wins in the 100 back, 200 back, and 200 IM. Freshman Aaron Regan won the 400 free and placed second in both the 200 free and the 200 fly, while sophomore Patricia Yam won the 200 fly and placed second in the 100 fly. As far as my team, the cross country team, we had a week off to prepare for the upcoming Northeast Conference Championships. We caught up with the cross country coach Larry O'Hara to talk about the conference race at Homedale Park.
We've been led by Megan Kinsella, who's a junior, two-time all-conference runner. She led us at the Delaware Invitational. And Dylan Bernard, a senior, who's been a three-time all-conference selection as well. He's been leading us on the men's side. So we're looking for senior Gigi Jibalisco and junior Chris Swisco to really step up. I think they both have a really solid shot at getting all NEC. And if we want to achieve our goals, I think they're going to need to be right around the top 14 for that. For the women, I think Colleen Smith and Catherine Frankie are going to be X factors for us. I think Mackenzie and Megan Kinsella are going to do really well. And I think if Megan and Colleen can get into the top 20 or top 25, it's really going to be key for us. Also, sophomore Desi Scott, who was our second runner last year at the NEC, she's really improving this year and is really rounding into shape at the right time. So I think she's also going to be a key for us at the conference. At the conference meet, we're mainly looking to improve our place from last year. We really didn't graduate too many of our scorers from last year, so we had everybody coming back. So even after last year's conference meet, we were really looking to improve on it. On both the men's and women's side last year, we were seventh, so we're definitely hoping for top five for each team. But I think we have aspirations of a little bit higher. Just all depends on who shows up on the day. If we can get 2 to 3 men in all conference, I think we have a pretty good shot of getting right around fourth place or even higher. And same with the women. If we can get our top 2 or 3 under 20th or 25th place, I think we have a really good shot of being right around fourth place or even better. So I think we're just trying to improve on last year and maybe do something special on that day.
I would like to congratulate women's soccer senior Alicia Miller for being named the Mount Athlete of the Week. As you heard earlier, Miller posted 8 saves in the pair of wins and became the program's all-time career leader in shutouts with 11 with the 1-0 win against Central Connecticut State on Friday. Miller was one of 10 women soccer players honored before the game against Quinnipiac on Sunday for Senior Day. We are winding down the fall slate with some key Northeast Conference games coming up this week. The men's soccer team will host St. Francis PA on Friday night at 7 p.m. for its final regular season home game. The squad will also travel to Robert Morris on Sunday. Women's swimming will be home on Friday at 6 p.m. and on Saturday starting at 12 p.m. The Mount will host Manhattan, NJIT, and VMI on Friday, and Manhattan, NJIT, and McDaniel on Saturday. The women's soccer team concludes its regular season with a pair of pivotal league games at Bryant on Friday and at Sacred Heart on Sunday. My team, the cross country team, will be at the Northeast Conference Championships on Saturday. Remember that you can get all of your Mount Athletics news at mountathletics.com and check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube by searching for Mount Athletics. Once again, I'm Gigi Jibalisco, and this was This Week in Mount Athletics.